You're listening to the audio production of Reshape Your Life. Don't Settle Because You Are Worth It by Ali Landry. Published by Thomas Nelson and read by the author. This book is dedicated to every woman who believes she is worthy of a life that is fulfilling and spectacular. My prayer, from my heart to yours, is that this book meets you exactly where you are. Introduction. The perfect time for a reshape. We cannot become what we want by remaining what we are. Max Dupree. Reshape. Verb. To give a new form or orientation to. Noun. A life-altering event that changes the course of your life or transforms you. Hi, I'm Ali Landry, wife, mom, daughter, sister, actress, host, entrepreneur, and wellness explorer. Like so many of us, I wear many hats. Tapping into my own greatness, recognizing my superpower, and encouraging other women to do it for themselves drives my dedication to see all women reshape the areas of their life that are no longer serving them. I believe it's never too late to pivot or change to create a life you love. It's all about finding the best resources, education, tools, and community to take action and fight for it, never settling for less than what you deserve. I love seeing a woman completely thrive. When I see a woman not living with desire, joy, or fulfillment, it breaks my heart. So often, we as women get stuck. We get stuck in relationships that diminish us, jobs that don't suit us, eating habits that deplete us, schedules that exhaust us, mindsets that steal our vision, and routines that no longer serve us. It's not like any of us get stuck on purpose. Life happens. But as poet Maya Angelou famously said to Oprah Winfrey, when you know better, you do better. I have chosen to educate myself and assess every area of my life over the last 20 years in an attempt to build the very best version of myself every day. What about you? Are you going to face what needs to change and choose to custom design a life that you love? When you recognize an area of your life that needs a reshape, either big or small, what is your self-talk? I hope you tell yourself that you're worth it. God created each of us on purpose. I hope my reshape experience will inspire you for yours. What is a reshape? We've all had those times when we realize a certain area of life is no longer serving us. We must make a decision to either settle or step up and figure it out. There are seasons of reshaping, and while some are more significant than others, all are important to our quality of life and to who we ultimately become. In this book, I'll share some of my own reshapes. These include defining moments in my life, some very public and some intensely private, all of them pivotal. While some were life-changing and beautiful, others were extremely uncomfortable, even heartbreaking. They challenged me and pushed me to step into life at a whole new level. Because of them, I was forced to do a deep dive into myself and learn to approach life differently. These moments were transformational for me because I did the work, reshaping what wasn't working for me anymore. Honestly, the vision for this book came from these reshape moments. Rude awakening. What started me on this journey was landing my dream job, a daily syndicated talk show called Hollywood Today Live. I dreamed of hosting a talk show for years, and this seemed a perfect fit for me. On paper, the schedule looked great for a busy wife and mom of three. I'd start early in the morning, get in a workout, then be available for my family in the afternoons. The reality was quite different from what I'd imagined. While it seemed like I should have been on top of the world, thrilled, living my best life, in reality, I was exhausted. I was losing my hair. I had poor digestion, low sex drive, mild depression. The list goes on. I felt so off. I didn't feel sick enough to see a doctor, but at the same time, I knew that something wasn't right. My girlfriends passed it off as aging, but that didn't sit well with me. I wasn't going to settle. So I dug down deep. I found the fire inside of me to get to the bottom of how I was feeling. Then I got to work. The results were nothing short of transformational. I'll share the full story later in chapter 3, but for now, just know that I found the vibrancy in life that I so desired. That's what I believe every woman deserves, and I am determined to help you get to yours too. The desire to reach the full potential of who I was created to be is foundational for how I have built my life, both personally and professionally. When trials come, as they inevitably do, I walk into the situation knowing I'm not going to stay stuck and let circumstances dictate my future. I have a mindset of thriving to never settle. Reshaping is not a one-time thing. It's a journey. Whether your heart, mind, soul, or health need a change, you are worth the effort to spend the time and find the resources you need to create a life you love and fully live into your purpose. I've worked to build a community of people who feel like sunshine and who recognize my superpowers. I would love to be a part of your community to cheer you on, help you with your own reshape, and support your dreams and visions for your life. My encouragement to you is this: do not settle, because you are worth it. We only get one life, and we should make it a masterpiece. The birth of Reshape. I created my lifestyle company, Reshape, to build a community where women could find the education, resources, tools, wellness experts, game-changing products, and inspiration for a total reshape, heart, mind, soul, and health. When I started down the road to reshape my health, it was a big task to research and find the information I was looking for that could help me take responsibility for figuring out and fixing what was going on. At the time, I would have loved to have found one place with a trusted, curated, broad scope of resources that could guide me to achieve my goals and reach my reshape a little faster and more efficiently. That's why I went to work and built the lifestyle company, Reshape. I love to research and become knowledgeable about products and services. Many of my girlfriends don't have the time, don't know where to look, and don't know the questions to ask. I enjoy being in the hot seat, asking the questions, trying the treatments, and being the guinea pig so I can report back. I will give most anything one try. And taking you on the adventure with me makes it all the more fun and worthwhile. I have worked through some major health issues and dealt with tragedy, loss, heartbreak, and betrayal, all of which catapulted me into a necessary reshape to move my life beyond my circumstances. I was determined not to let difficulties define me. I've experienced tremendous growth personally, along with an increased internal strength after doing the necessary work. As women, we are at our best when we are supporting one another. My hope is that this book will meet you where you are and be a guiding light for your own personal reshape exploration. Do you need a reshape? So what about you? What areas of your life need a reshape? I look at overall wellness and thriving in life from an integrative perspective. Our hearts, minds, souls, and health are intertwined. It's like my friend and mentor Robin Sharma says, the mindset, heart set, health set, and soul set are all connected. As we grow in heart, mind, health, and soul, that releases pressure in all the other areas of your life. As you step back and look at any area you'd like to reshape, recognize the need to evaluate and touch on one of these most intimate areas. Often, addressing one area of struggle will trigger struggle in the other areas. We can't reshape one area without looking at another. I'm not saying to reshape everything at once. Just be aware and notice how one area impacts others. The patterns we create for ourselves can often become the primary factor when we get off track and part of our life begins to drag us down. We get into patterns for all sorts of reasons. And as we know, patterns are hard to break. To counteract patterns, I'm a big fan of routines, specific routines to help stay on track, make the most of the day, and bring purpose to life. Patterns and routines are different in my eyes. While patterns can happen by accident, routines are intentional. What is your daily pattern of life? How are the weekdays and weekend treating you? Are you waking up exhausted? Does life hit you on a Monday morning like a Mack truck? Or do you have a morning routine in place that serves your overall wellness so you feel energized and ready to take on the world? My routine was waking up, hitting the snooze button, having my kids run into the room and hustling to make breakfast, get them to school, followed by full days of work and then family responsibilities. That brought me to end my day with just getting through dinner, getting kids to bed, watching Netflix on my iPad in bed with baked Cheetos until I dozed off. Spending months in this pattern is only going to bring us to one place, completely agitated and unsettled. It was a pattern I didn't set out to have. Nonetheless, this pattern became my daily life, and it came from the circumstances I was facing at the time. I decided it was impacting not only me, but my family and the atmosphere in our home. I'd had enough. I made a commitment to myself to figure out a better sleep strategy and morning routine. When I put these two systems in place, my life completely transitioned to become more manageable in every area, and I no longer felt drained or unmotivated before the day began. How is your health? I can tell you, mine needed a major overhaul. I was struggling in some areas and was just living with it, thinking problems would go away or I would get to them at some point or later. It was only when I started working on the daily talk show, Hollywood Today Live, that all of my issues became significantly elevated. It forced me to look for the support I needed. Again, I'll dive into this more in the next chapter. Why do we as women always put ourselves in last place on our list of priorities? I think it's our nature to serve others, but not taking care of ourselves impacts not only us, but everyone around us. How many times have we been told this? Have you, like me, spent too much time at different moments in life focused on that magic number? Have you thought that if you could just lose X number of pounds, you would be happy? I have. And it's a really uncomfortable truth for me to admit it. It makes me sad when I realize that I let that thought creep in. The funny thing is, I've hit the magic number that I dreamt about before. I honestly thought that all of a sudden, when I saw that number in the scale, everything in my life would be unicorns and rainbows. But it wasn't. I was still at times sad, unsatisfied with life, and full of anxiety. I should have known better. Life doesn't mysteriously transform when a certain number shows up on the scale. Choosing to love your whole self at every turn on your journey is a choice only you can make. Sometimes this choice requires a deliberate reshape across all areas of your life. Heart, mind, soul, and health. How is your environment? Does it give you life or drain your life? I am big on clearing out the clutter around our home because it not only makes me feel restless to look at it and know I need to do something about it, but it makes my mind even more cluttered, leaving less space for thinking, planning, dreaming, and anything creative I want to do. This is an area most of us would benefit from reshaping and implementing a routine that helps.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.